Good morning, friends. As we know, infection of the central nervous system are very important, and the disease related to central nervous system, they present with a significant morbidity as well as mortality. And most of the disease related to CNS, they need a prompt that they usually come as a medical emergency in the hospital and need prompt treatment. So many of the syndromes of central nervous system are like meningitis, encephalitis, encephalopathy, space occupying lesions, and there are many more. So today we will touch one of the most important topic of the CNS, that is the viral encephalitis. I will also tell you about the encephalopathy, what is the difference between the two. So let's start. So what is encephalitis? That is, it is an acute inflammation of the brain parenchyma. And usually this encephalitis is accompanied with the meningitis also, where there is the involvement of meninges. Now, for encephalitis, most of the reason is the infectious agent only, and these are usually viruses. Sometimes they could be parasites or it could be autoimmune. Then what is encephalopathy? As encephalitis is the acute inflammation of the brain parenchyma, this encephalopathy is a diffuse disease, that is all of the brain is involved, and it is a diffuse disease of brain which alters its function or structure. Usually the cause for the encephalitis are the infectious agent, but for encephalopathy these are the non-infectious cause, some metabolic disorder, or like in case seen in the hepatic encephalopathy. So they are usually non-infectious. Now, what are the causative agents for encephalitis? That is the herpes family, that is the herpes simplex virus 1. Usually HSV-1 is more involved, and it is one of the most common cause of the sporadic encephalitis. This is important MCQ also. So HSV-1 is most common cause of sporadic encephalitis. Then cytomegalovirus, varicella zoster, Epstein-Barr. Then among the arboviruses, there are many big list of arboviruses. What are the arboviruses? That is, these are the viruses which are transmitted by arthropod-borne vectors. So Japanese encephalitis is the most common epidemic encephalitis. That is the cause of most common epidemic encephalitis in India. Whereas in USA, it is the West Nile virus. Then rabies virus, Nipah and Hendra virus, rare causes may enteroviruses and mumps virus. Then encephalopathy, these infectious agents, although they are being said to be encephalopathies, but they are not encephalopathy, they are the chronic encephalitis. So previous slide I have told you about the acute encephalitis, so the presentation is acute, and here also there is inflammation, and but it is a chronic case. But usually the term encephalopathy is being used, still it has not been removed. So I have covered here under the encephalopathy heading only, that is a slow virus disease, which include the progressive multifocal leukoencephalopathy, then measles encephalitis, rubella encephalitis, then prions disease. So these patients having the CNS diseases, either encephalitis or encephalopathy, they present with a common clinical feature. And what are these clinical features? How will you suspect that this patient is having some CNS disorder, that is some distortion in the consciousness, that is an altered level of consciousness? Either the patient, one extreme is the, that is the mildly lethargic, and other extreme is the comatose patient. Then there can be presentation with seizures. It can be focal or it could be generalized. Then hallucinations, agitation, personality change, behavior disorder, or psychotic state. Then certain neurological signs can also be noticed, that is, that can be focal. Or it can be diffuse. That is aphasia, that is the person is not able to talk. Aphasia, ataxia, there is some incoordination while walking, that is the ataxia. Then upper motor neuron or lower motor neuron palsy. Involuntary movements can be there, like myoclonic jerks, tremor, cranial nerve palsies and involvement of meninges, so neck rigidity. Now, what will be the presentation in the CSF? So, most important sample when there is a CNS system involved, that is the cerebrospinal fluid. And what we notice in case of encephalitis, that is they will be lymphocyte predominance. So, in the bacterial causes, as we know, maximum are the virus causes, so lymphocyte count will be high. In the bacterial causes, usually the neutrophil count goes high. And mildly elevated protein level and a normal glucose level. Now we cover one by one the causes of encephalitis. So HSV encephalitis, that is the most common cause of acute sporadic encephalitis. It generally involves the temporal lobe. So these are important MCQs that it causes the involvement in the temporal lobe. HSV1 is more common than HSV2. In children, usually the child get infection from outside and primary infection is there and it reaches to the CNS through the olfactory bulb. In adults, usually the adults, they have the infection in the childhood only, and this virus remains in the trigeminal ganglia in the inactivated, or you say in the latent form. And later on, whenever the immunity goes down, there will be reactivation of this latent form of the virus, and it can cause the infection. So we can detect this virus DNA in the CSF, and for treatment you can give the acyclovir, which works on this virus. Then comes the second cause, that is the arbovirus encephalitis. So there is a huge list. One of the families, the Togavidae, which involve this eastern equine encephalitis virus, western equine encephalitis virus, meningeolin equine encephalitis virus. So that is the seen maximum in the America, and vector are in like eastern Aedes and Culex are there, western also Aedes. So Aedes, Culex, both are there. Then come another family, that is the Flavivirid. So very important is the Japanese bee encephalitis, that I will tell you in detail, because it is most common cause of epidemic encephalitis in India. So it is distributed in Southeast Asia. So Asia mein aapka Japanese bee encephalitis is the predominant virus which causing the encephalitis. Vector is Culex titanorhynchus. Reservoirs are pigs and birds. Then other are St. Louis encephalitis, West Nile encephalitis. So West Nile is common in America. Then this vector are Culex, Aedes, and Anopheles. Then many more are there, like Murray Valley encephalitis virus. Then there is another family, Bunia Verde, where there is a California encephalitis virus. Then another family is Rio Verde, Colorado tick fever virus. Then Rhabdo Verde, that is the Chandipura virus. So few cases of this Chandipura virus has been detected in India, and its vector is different, that is the sand fly. So this list of arbovirus encephalitis, few of the names must be known, what are the different, in which family they are coming. And when we read in detail, usually a short note can come on the Japanese bee encephalitis, it is very common in India. So what is this Japanese bee encephalitis? So this has been first discovered in Japan, therefore it has been named as Japanese bee encephalitis. And large epidemics have been seen in China, India and other parts of Asia. So mainly in Asia, it is the dominant virus which is causing this encephalitis. And causative agent, that is, it belongs to Flavivirid, so it is a flavivirus. It is transmitted by Culex mosquito, that is the species being also asked, so it is Culex titanorhynchus. Now this virus is maintained in the nature with the cycle which involves the mosquitoes, birds and pigs. So these pigs, they act as an amplifier in which virus live. So pigs kya hai yahan pe reservoirs hai, where the virus live in them and it will multiply. So whenever there is no cycle in the human beings, so yahan pe maintained rehte hain, therefore they are being called as the reservoirs. Heron also acts as reservoir host. Pigs are the amplifier host. So pigs jo hote hain, they do not manifest, they are only amplifying this सो उनमें डिजीज मैनिफेस्ट नहीं होगी बट दे आर एम्पलीफाइंग द दिस वायरस वायरस इज मल्टीप्लाइंग इन दैम एंड फ्रॉम द ह्यूमन इट विल नॉट ट्रांसफर टू एनी अदर वन सो इट इज अ डेड एंड इवेंट वेन द ह्यूमन बींग्स कॉट दिस इन्फेक्शन नेचुरल इन्फेक्शन हैज बीन सीन इन द अदर आर्ड्रिड बर्ड्स ऑल दिस So major vector, I have already told you, and these vectors, they have more predilection for the cattle. But cattle, they do not develop viremia. That means the virus is not coming in the blood. Therefore, from the cattle, it will not spread to anyone. Because pigs are getting the infection, virus is multiplying, viremia is there. That means virus is present in the blood. So when the mosquito again will bite, it will take up the virus. So new mosquito will get infected and will transfer to the human beings. But in case of cattle, as they are not developing viremia, so the virus cannot get spread to other beings from the cattle. So that is the reason that in our country, this human infection has been limited only few. Zones are there where there is a many cases have been noted. So this high cattle pig ratio in India has been a factor which is limiting the human infection. Otherwise, it will be a big problem. So this is the cycle from like this mosquito are taking up the infection and they are spreading it. Now, what are the clinical features of this Japanese bee encephalitis? So, usually in encephalitis, I have told you in the previous slides only, usually the features are same. And this most of the human infections, they are subclinical. So, that is the, it is also a very good example of iceberg phenomenon. Iceberg means that is the maximum part is submerged and we cannot see it as a problem. Only the tip is being seen. So the cases which we are noticing, that is they are presenting with the symptom or certain signs, so they are very few and many persons have the infection but they are not being presented with certain symptoms, so they are being gone as unnoticed. So the ratio of inapparent to clinical cases, 300 is to 1. That is only one patient is manifesting and 300 are not manifesting. And what is the presentation in clinical cases? So one is the prodromal phase. So what is being seen in the prodromal phase? That is the symptom of the viral infection only. They are being seen as the, what we say, that is the myalgia, fever is there. And there may be, presentation can be acute or subacute, abrupt. Then second stage comes encephalitis stage. So in encephalitis stage, there will be acute onset of fever, then mental confusion, disorientation, delirium, seizure. So all those symptoms which I have told you in the previous slide, so these will be the encephalitis stage. Then comes the late stage and the sequelae. So late stage may, in the convalescent stage, the patient may recover fully, or they may have some neurological deficit that can be permanently or they can be fatality. The problem is that when the person have this neurological deficit, so that can be seen in many cases, that is up to 50% can have this neurological deficit and case fatality rate is also high, that is 20 to 40%. So that is the problem that they can be late stage complication, also permanent disability, and the fatality rate is also high. How we can diagnose? That is by serology. MAC ELISA is there. No specific therapy is available. We have to give only symptomatic treatment, and we have effective vaccine available. So what is this vaccine? That is, one is the aformalin inactivated mouse brain vaccine. That is using the Nakayama strain, which have been prepared from Japan. Now in India, in the Central Research Institute at Kasauli. The other vaccine is the live attenuated vaccine, that is the SA14142 vaccine. So it is a cell line drive vaccine. Which cell line have been used? Primary hamster kidney cell line. So subcutaneously single dose is needed, then booster dose is given after 1 year. And in the nation immunization schedule, it has been included in the 1 to 15 years. So the area which are endemic for this Japanese bee encephalitis, so 181 endemic district have been selected. So there it is being compulsory to give, that is 9 to 12 months and then 16 to 24 months. So that is being included in the national immunization schedule. Then the combined vaccine, that is a genetically engineered JE vaccine. So isme inhone they have combined the SA1442 vaccine with the yellow fever, so that it will cover both the important viruses. So this is yellow fever 17D strain. So one is inactivated, another is live attenuated. So this live attenuated is being preferred, and this combined vaccine which includes both yellow fever as well as the Japanese bee encephalitis. Then comes the West Nile encephalitis. So this West Nile virus, it is also related to Japanese encephalitis virus only, flavivirus, transmitted by Culex mosquito. It is zoonotic and it is maintained in nature by transmission between the birds and mosquitoes. Incubation period is 3 to 14 days. 80% of the people, they remain asymptomatic, and the remaining can have the fever or can have the encephalitis. Diagnosis. So maximum cases in the virals, we have diagnosed by serology. Usually the ELISA is being preferred, and these cell lines is usually for research, for vaccine preparation. So this how you can easily can retain that. It will be easy in all the topic related to viruses, that is ELISA. So IgM antibody capture ELISA, then IgG ELISA, if you are going, that paired sera is needed, and viral RNA detection, ultimate, if you have any problem, you can go to the PCR. Treatment, supportive measures, no specific antiviral drugs available. Then comes the Nipah and the Hendra viruses. So they belong to Paramyxoviridae family, to which these paramyxoviruses are there, like respiratory syncytial virus is there, human metapneumovirus are there. So to this group it belongs, the Nipah and Hendra, and they have they are zoonotic, involving the these animals. So this Hendra virus, it was first isolated in 1994, so it is a recent virus only, and it has been detected in the Hendra, that is the Australia, and Nipah virus been discovered in 1999 in Malaysia. Reservoirs are the fruit bats, and they are also the natural host. So where they are being distributed? So Hendra virus, they are confined to horses in Australia, and Nipah virus in pigs in Malaysia. Nipah virus, it is emerging especially in the Southeast Asia countries. Where Nipah virus has been seen, Bangladesh, India, Thailand and Malaysia. Transmission, that is how we are getting this infection, that is from the fluid and excretion of the horses. Nipah virus may, if the person is coming direct contact with the fruit bats, pigeons, so there they can get. Then another mode has been seen of that of raw date palm sap. Human to human transmission has also been seen in few cases. Clinically, same presentation. Whenever we are talking of any virus causing the encephalitis, usually the same features. So all these have been grouped in the encephalitis. So almost incubation is also same. Fever, headache, myalgia, then altered consciousness, you know, so the same feature are there. All the, but the progression of the disease is very fast. Severe cases can progress to coma within 48 hours and death. So the progression of the disease is very fast in case of the Nipah and the Hendra virus. Then laboratory diagnosis, you can go for the PCR for the throat and nasal swab from CSF. Then antibody detection can be done by ELISA and immunohistochemistry. No antiviral drugs available. Subunit vaccine has been made using the Hendra G protein. And recently this vaccine have been tried in Australia to protect the horses against the Hendra virus. and it can be used in humans as well, not yet been given. So that is all for this encephalitis. I will make another within few weeks, within few days, sorry. That is on the slow virus. I will cover under that topic, slow virus in the prions. And I will also try to cover the rabies, which all come in this encephalitis group. So that is all for today's presentation. And hope you must have learned. Thanks for paying attention.